Hello. This video is for an elementary statistics student towards the beginning of the course where you learn how to organize your data into a frequency table. So this data that we have here represents 20 randomly selected students and their ages of each of these students. Okay, so rather than having raw data just listed, we usually, especially when we have larger numbers pieces of data, we like to organize it in a frequency table. So we're going to go through the steps of creating a table, and then the next slide will be the actual putting it together in the columns that you should expect to calculate on each of these tables. Okay, so here we have our 20 ages of our sample. The first thing we have to figure out, and the first thing that we're going to look at, is right here with this number of classes. That's usually given to you in the problem. If it's not, using five or six classes is usually appropriate for most data sets. So what we have to figure out right now, if we're going to break this into five classes, is how many ages should go into each class. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we're going to find the range of the data set. And the range is really just the maximum value minus the minimum value. Okay, so in this case, our maximum age group in this sample was 45. Our minimum was 19. So there's an age span of 26 years in this sample. Okay, so that's our range. So the second thing we're going to do with that range is we're going to figure out if we have to span 26 years in our frequency table and we want to break that into five classes, we're going to find how wide should each class be. So that's called our class width. Okay, so the class width, I'm just going to abbreviate it CW. That's going to be your range divided by your number of classes. Okay, so our range we found was 26. In our number of classes, we want to break into 5. Okay, so this comes out to be 5.2. Whoops. Okay, so that comes out to be 5.2. Okay, so that, we don't want to have any, our frequency table with a class width that's a fraction. So what we do is we're going to round always up to the next whole number. Okay. I'm saying up, and it's always up no matter how big that number is. We're going to round up. So our class width, even though it was 5.2, we're going to round it up to 6. Okay. The reason we always round up is because if we were to round that down to 5, then one of our larger pieces of data would probably be left out of our table, wouldn't have a class to go into. So there's our first two steps that we're always going to do. And now we're ready to start actually creating our classes and determining how many pieces of data fall into each class. So I'm going to move on to my next. Okay, we took our data set and we figured out what is the span in our data set, which is our range. And we found our range by taking our maximum value minus our minimum. We found that to be our 26. Okay, that was where we started. Then we figured out how many years for this particular sample, how many years should go into each class. So we took our range, which is 26, and we cut it into 5 equal pieces. Okay, and that's where we got our 5.2. We can't have a class width to be a fraction or decimal, so we always round it up to the next whole number. So that's how we ended at our class width of 6. Okay, then we moved on. Sorry about that little cutout. So we were looking at the cumulative frequency. So like I was saying, it's very similar to the relative frequency, and that's just another way to express how many pieces of data are in each class. But instead of looking at each class individually, we look at the cumulative frequency, which is how many people are in each class in that one and all the ones before it. So the way I always describe this is, if you have a cumulative exam, it includes all the material that you've covered to that point all the way on before that. So cumulative frequency, we're going to add up all the classes at that class and before. So the first one, there was no classes before, so that cumulative frequency is just 10. Okay, so the next class has two additional, so my cumulative frequency for this one will be 12. And then we add the 6 more for the next class, so that one will be 18. And then we add one more, which is going to make 19. And then 20. Okay, so the sum of my cumulative frequencies should always be, or let's not say sum. Let's get rid of that. The last value, this last value should always be n. Because if we've summed up all the data points, we should end at how many we had total, which is 20. So this is a completed frequency table with all the possible columns that you would ever have to have. Sometimes all you need is the class limits and frequency. So let's just quickly recap. And then we started filling in our actual table. So we started at our class limit. Our lower class limit should be 19, the minimum value. Okay, this right here to start at our minimum. Okay, and then we build from there. If our class width is 6, we add 6 to each of those lower class limits. And then we fill in our upper class limits so that there's no overlap or gap really between each of the classes. And our frequencies we found by figuring out how many people out of that sample fall into each category. From there we filled in our midpoints and boundaries and our two different types of frequency. So at this point, once you have this table completed, you're ready to either draw a histogram, which is a bar graph, or sometimes we do an ogive. There's multiple different types of graphs we can do at this point. So you can watch the next video, which is going through the steps of a histogram and an ogive.